Hey guys, the Modders here, welcome back to the new video. So in today's video, I'm going to share with you a vehicle pack for your Grand Theft Auto San Andreas. And this vehicle pack is not like other vehicle packs who sucks FPS a lot. This vehicle pack is completely designed for your low-end PC and it looks very similar to the original vehicles of San Andreas. So in simple language, you can say it pre-textured your original vehicles of San Andreas, you know. So the size of this vehicle is also less. And if you talk about the vehicles, then almost every vehicle has been replaced from the game, you know. So do you want to know how to install and how to use this vehicle pack in your low-end PC? Please make sure to watch this video till end. Now, some of you will ask, what do you mean by low-end PC? So let me explain you the system requirements in order to play this mod. Well, if you want to play this mod into 30 FPS, then your PC should have this type of specification. First of all, you need at least 2GB of RAM and a dual core processor and 1GB of dedicated graphics card. Well, if you don't have 1GB of dedicated graphics card, then also you don't need to worry about it. If you have Intel SD, then you can easily play this vehicle mode into 30 FPS. Well, that's all the specification of this mod. In order to play this mod into 30 FPS on lowest setting as possible and 1280x720 resolution, right? Now let's talk about the recommended specs in order to play this mod into 60 FPS, you know. Now if you also want to pair a graphics mod in it, then you should have at least 4GB RAM and would any dual core processor, and you need 2GB of dedicated graphics card. GT710 will be best for you. If you don't have GT710, then Intel SD 4000 will be greatest of this mod in the combination of graphics mod. Well, that's all the specification of this mod. We should move to our installation video. So without any further ado, let's get started to the video, guys. But before we get started, you know what you have to do is you have to like on this video, share this video to as much you can. And if you're new, then what are you doing? Please make sure to hit that subscribe button, my friend. So yeah, without any further ado, let's dive into the video, guys. Alright guys, so as you can see, we are in our desktop screen. And first thing, you will need these two files. Make sure to check description for more information. First one is your optional 2.0. It's very important in order to install this vehicle pack, right? And second one is our vehicle pack. And this is called 90CVP Reborn 2.0. So second thing you need to do is just extract your optional 2.0 folder into your desktop or any specific folder you want to extract. Now once your optional 2.0 folder has been extracted, then just simply open your game directory from here and then open your optional 2.0 folder, and then from here you have to open your SLEOAS Elevator Plus mod loader. And I will suggest you to use clean GTA San Andreas. If you don't have clean GTA San Andreas, then all the way you can check description for more information, right? Now the second thing you need to do is copy only these selected files. First one is Leo, second one is mod loader, third one is your base.dll, fourth one is your sleo.asi, and then just copy these all selected files into your game directory. And please do not copy other files, right? Now from here, what you need to do is go back. Now I'm gonna give you a simple trainer, right? It's called the RZL trainer. It will help you to spawn your vehicle. Now in this video, I'm going to give you the two trainers, right? First one, when you press Ctrl plus C, it will open up cheat menu, and second one, when you press F2. And this is the second one. This is called RZL trainer, right? Now go back, and then from here what you need to do is open your widescreen fix, open your scripts folder, and then just copy these two files and then hit on replace if it asks. Now one more thing you have to keep in your mind. If you want to avoid graphics error, you know, when you install some mods in your GTA San Andreas, then textures are missing. So if you want to fix the textures, then from here what you need to do is open your graphics fix and then just copy all of these files into your game directory. Okay, and then hit on replace if it asks. Alright fellas, so we have successfully installed our optional 2.0 mods into our game directory, right? Now minimize or close both of this window and then extract to main mod. It's very simple to extract, you know, you have to click on extract files and then it will extract your file into your desktop or any specific folder you want to extract. Now once your extraction has been completed, then simply, you know what you need to do is just open your game directory and then the extracted mod we have just done, right? Now you don't need to install these files, right? Open your mod loader and then just simply drag and drop 90CVP into your mod loader, right? Okay, so it will take some time depending upon your PC specification, and the size of this mod is also less than 500 MB. Well, if you have any problem while getting my files, then you can check description for more information. Now just hold on a second. It will take a couple of seconds, you know. I think it's done. Okay, it's completely done, right? Now all we need to do is show a gameplay. Now just run your gds.exe or env.exe. Now if you don't have env.exe, then it's completely presented in my Opsil 2.0 folder, right? Now just open your env.exe and then paste in your game, run your game and enjoy, fellas, right? Now just run your env.exe and then your game will 100% start. So alright guys, so as you can see we are in our game and let's see what happened to our vehicles, you know. So let me show you every vehicle. So unfortunately I can't show you the every vehicle, but I can show you some few vehicles. Just hold on a second, let me show you my favorite vehicles. So one of my favorite vehicle from this game is the Cheetah, you know. Look at the beautiful Ferrari car, you know. Okay, so your old car should be replaced. So as you can see, this is our Infernus, or I guess this is Infernus. No, this is not Infernus, this is ZR350. By the way, look at the beautiful lightning, you know. And one more thing I want to show to you. Okay, see the magic, right? It headlights automatically opens at night, and when the night time goes off, the lights also goes off. So that's interesting, right? So thank you so much for watching till end, guys. I hope you all enjoyed this video. If you enjoyed this video, then please make sure to leave a like on this video, share this video to as much you can, and if you're new, then you know what you need to do. Is I'm not gonna repeat every time. So yeah, as always, I'll see you into the next one. Till then, goodbye.